Arts are huge in Toledo, and we're lucky enough to have a high school that specializes in them. Beverly Huss and Doug Mead are here from the Toledo School for the Arts, and now is the time to get your child into the lottery. Good morning, folks. Thanks for joining us today.
Morning. Thanks so much for having us. We appreciate it.
Absolutely. So this is kind of a unique enrollment situation here at Toledo School for the Arts. Talk a little bit about this lottery system and how students can get enrolled there at the school.
So we have to enroll by lottery because we have more applicants that want to come to TSA than we have room for. So there's one lottery for every grade, and parents fill out an application online, and then they have to provide some supporting documents for us, and then they'll be issued a lottery number. And the deadline to apply and get those supporting documents is February 26th at 3 p.m., and then the lottery will happen on March 26th.
Okay, that's the day that all of the students kind of wait around, right, and wait and see if the number gets called there. So talk a little bit about why. You said you have too many applicants than you have space for. So why is TSA so popular?
Well, we're blessed to have a very good problem with that. And I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that when we have an absolutely extraordinary faculty and staff that just keeps raising the bar on our creative output every single year. And frankly, even just coming to work every day, it really is just an amazingly dynamic environment, both from the teacher standpoint and the student standpoint. So I think when students and families come in and see that for the first time and they're in the building, it's really infectious. And I think that's one of the great things about being here, and it's one of the great things about studying here. And as students grow from being sixth graders through graduation, you really just see this artistic and creative development that is just unmatched. I've never seen anything like it, and this is going into my sixth year now.
So what types of programs do you have? We see it looks like some music. Do you do theater, or what other kinds of programs do you guys have there at the school?
Oh, it's absolutely all across the board. Everything from theater, photography, music, dance, to now some of the more business side of the artistic programs outside of the stage. So graphic design, video and film, audio recording. So we're really trying to expand a lot of what we do. And I think it's really helped provide a broader experience for the students that we have in place.
Do the students get to kind of pick which track they want to go on, or do they kind of get like a little bit of everything? What is the experience like for them?
It actually is very much like selecting a college major. So as students go through as middle school, they kind of get exposure to all the different arts areas. And by the time they start as a ninth grader, they more or less select a track. And then that track really represents the electives that they're going to take through their high school career. So if you're a music track, then your elective courses are going to be much more geared toward music. So it's really fun for them to be able to start that process so early.
You know, I say this a lot on the show. I went to a performing arts high school myself, and I my track was theater, and I obviously didn't get into theater, but I have always said the skills that you learn in art school can really translate to so many different career opportunities. So talk a little bit about the importance of having that well-rounded arts education.
Oh, it's incredibly important. And I'm sure you use those skills every single day. And for us, it's about building those transferable skills. And it's not just about those students that are going to be going into the arts as a profession, but really making sure that they have that critical and creative sense of thinking that they can use in whatever avenue they choose to pursue. When we're able to do that, then we know we've been successful. The large majority of our students don't go into the arts, but I can guarantee you that they use all of the skills that they've learned as being an artist to their advantage, and it's made them much more successful.
Beverly, go through the dates with us again here, because parents, students are interested and they need to make sure that they get everything in by deadline.
Yeah, the deadline is 3 p.m. on Friday, February 26th to apply and provide all the supporting documents. That's a hard deadline, and the application is all online. We are here to help if anyone needs any assistance, but it is primarily done on the internet.
Okay, the address there on the screen. Folks, thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate it, and I'm sure you're going to get some really great, great students coming in for the next school year.
We appreciate it. Thanks so much, Amanda.
Yeah, take care.